Remember that a function is a set of ordered pairs. The domain of a function is the set of all its x values. So 9, negative 2, 2, and 3. The range is all its y values. So 2, negative 5, negative 1, negative 7. In a function, each x value can only be matched with one y value. Since there are no repeated x values here, this is a function. If our function is a finite set of ordered pairs like this one, we can just list the domain and range like we did here. But usually a function is an infinite set of ordered pairs, which can be shown as a graph like this one. Then we need to give the domain and range in interval notation instead of a list. To find the domain, which are the x values, we need to figure out how far the graph extends from left to right. On the x-axis, the point furthest to the left is negative 5, and furthest to the right is 3. In interval notation, this is negative 5 to 3, using square brackets since the endpoints are included. For the range, we need the lowest and highest points of the graph, lowest point, highest point, and extend them onto the y-axis. The lowest point has a y value of negative 2.1. The highest point's y value is 2.8. So the range is from negative 2.1 from the bottom up to the top value of 2.8. Square brackets for both domain and range since the endpoints are included. To find the domain for the function shown in this graph, we could imagine projecting the graph onto the x-axis. If we shone a light from the top, where would the graph cast a shadow? Here on the left, and here on the right. Then think of shining a light from the bottom and see where the shadow would go. The shadow would be cast from the bottom if we shine the light up. The shadow would go here in the middle. Then the graph would extend forever in both directions. We end up with a shadow on the entire x-axis, so the interval goes from negative infinity to positive infinity. Always use parentheses for infinity. Or we could think of compressing the graph against the axis. So now let's look at the range. For the range, think of compressing the graph against the y-axis. Imagine a wall squeezing in from the left and squeezing in from the right. The bottom of the graph is here at negative 2, and the top of the graph extends to infinity. So the range goes from negative 2 to infinity. Square bracket on the negative 2, parenthesis on infinity. Here's another graph. Squeeze the graph from the top and bottom toward the x-axis to find the domain. The x-axis would be covered all the way from 2 all the way to the left of the graph, or to negative infinity. Now, we always report the domain from the left to the right. So when we report the domain, we need to start with negative infinity and then go to 2. For the range, squeeze the graph toward the y-axis, squeezing in from the left and the right. The y-axis ends up covered all the way to the top and all the way to the bottom. So the range is from lowest to highest, negative infinity to the bottom, and positive infinity to the top. On my math lab, it's a little trickier to interpret the way that they draw the graphs. So let's take a look at one of those. Is this the graph of a function? Well, we use the vertical line test. If we draw a vertical line, it would cross more than one point at a time. So this graph is not a function. To find the domain and range, we have to infer that if the graph is drawn all the way up to the edge of the visible grid, they mean that it extends forever. So there really should be arrow tips on this graph. For the domain, project or compress the graph toward the x-axis. So the point furthest to the left, if it's projected down, would touch the x-axis at, looks like, negative 4, and then it extends forever to the right, so to infinity. So for our domain, it would go from negative 4 on the left to infinity on the right. We'll choose the one with the square brackets since the point negative 4 is included. For the range, we compress the graph toward the y-axis. That's harder to visualize since the graph is off the grid and it's not shown. But these imaginary arrow tips that should be there mean the graph is going forever up and forever down. So the graph would end up covering the entire y-axis, forever up and forever down. But from lowest to highest, that would be from negative infinity to positive infinity.